Children of all ages, welcome to the Lincoln Theater and Theater Arts Guild's production of the Broadway musical Sideshow. Prepare yourself for wonderment, excitement, thrills, and chills, but most importantly, heart. During the performance, please be respectful of the actors on stage. Keep talking to a minimum, refrain from flash photography, and please take a moment at this time to turn off your cell phones. We hope our performance of Sideshow will have you fleeing the theater to tell all of your friends and family to come see it. Now, sit back, hold your loved ones close, and come look at the freaks.
Come see our elegant geek, refined but deadly. ferocity of the cannibal king. We keep him chained up because we know he's hankering for a taste of one of you. And you are here for enlightenment, not stock for cannibal still. When our hand is helping, hold on, a grander poor boy who'll be eating. Oh, what living. As you can see, the cavalry king has been subdued.
Yes.
There's absolutely nothing to fear. Ladies and gentlemen, with great pride, misty-eyed, I now present the stars of our show. No duo is more simpatico, though the conditions call abnormality.
More?
Well, the Siamese twins, for example.
Sometimes I'm able to convince them to reveal their connection for those with a scientific interest in their condition. Of course, a small consideration would be helpful. $2 allows for total reveal of their fleshy leg. Ah, not nice. Oh, and don't get any ideas, These girls are my daughters, so look all you want, but no touching.
scout and press agent for the Orpheum Circuit. I believe you girls could play vaudeville.
Vaudeville?
We're sideshow exhibits. People like us don't perform in places like that.
Are you kidding? Every vaudeville star is unusual in some way.
You mean a freak?
Again, that's your term, not mine. But people don't pay to see the ordinary. Sophie Tucker, Fanny Bryce, W.C. Fields, they're all unique.
I guess now we're unique.
And I know how to sell that. I'm the guy who works the stars to play the shows. That Connor LeBrovi smokes. And fill the rows of theaters in Lexington's and Buffalo's with acts I pre-selected. Very well connected.
So are we.
I love how you can laugh at your situation. No self-pity. Buddy, come here.
No.
This is Buddy Foster, vocal coach, dance master, miracle worker.
I'm a performer too.
I can see you on the stage with lights and clubs. On top of Pumpville.
Say I'm not gonna tell you you're making a mistake. Tell you not to go, no, I won't. I'll only say what I've learned along my way. The devil you know beats the devil.
Over the past few weeks, you've all made me feel right at home. these wonderful girls, and I am thrilled to share what they've achieved. Ladies and gentlemen, and you who are both, I give you Daisy and Violet Hilton!
At first glance, you may think we're abnormal. We may strike you as different or strange. But our moods, whether relaxed or formal, are well within everyday range. We eat with a fork, we sleep in a bed, we walk with our feet on the floor. We sit in a chair, we even make bread like your typical girl next door. We stroll in the park, we wade in the lake, we love to go out and explore. We ask dear old dad for all we can take, like your typical girls next door. We slip. We play golf. We cook. We sew. And we play a mean game of tennis, a skill we are happy to
attraction? I'm not stealing anything. Don't get your fair share, whatever the girls earn.
How generous. Especially since my fair share is 100%. You see, I own these girls.
Own them? Hasn't anyone told you this is America?
I don't need to explain anything to you. The twins are fully aware of the situation. Aren't you girls? Now, I think you owe these gentlemen an apology for wasting their time teaching you to dance. Violet?
I'm sorry.
That's my good girl. Daisy? Daisy!
I'm sorry.
Good. We wouldn't want our gentleman here to think I haven't taught you your proper manners. Now you go back to bed. It's nearly time for morning chores. Jake, lock it down. Gentlemen, I am quite...
quite certain that there are more important places for you to be, even at this rate, hour.
Yes! Just tell me one thing.
Haven't you caused enough trouble?
Daisy, you said that he isn't your father.
He's not.
But he owns you?
Sir is our legal guardian. We never knew our father.
So Sir married your mother.
No one married our mother.
Daisy, that's enough.
Maybe they could help us.
No one can help us.
How do we know?
This is private.
Violet, people have been staring at us from the moment we were born. From the beginning, our whole life has been a show. We were born in England. Our mother started screaming when she saw us two babies together. She couldn't bear to touch us.
She considered us punishment for her sin of being pregnant and unwed.
We were even told she prayed for us to die.
The midwife who delivered us.
She also performed abortions.
We always called her auntie.
Legally adopted us.
And took us in.
When I put you on display, you should thank me every day.
Auntie, we are so hungry. Can we eat?
I've had enough of your complaining. You've got me straining not to say something profane. Place me in vain, or should I deliver some bruises or a welt with the buckle on your would you rather I took a butcher's knife and cut you apart so you'd have a normal life? Good. Not another peep. We're going to see some doctors.
Houdini.
change our lives forever.
Oh my, aren't you beautiful?
Us?
Well, yes, you. And you. Phenomenal. Gorgeous.
Most people think we're strange.
And what's wrong with that?
Mr. Houdini, you're a magician.
Escapologist.
Even better. Teach me how to escape from her.
Well, sure, but are you ready?
I was joking.
No, you weren't. You can always be alone. Find a space that's all your own if you need to. Tap resources deep within to escape the clad and din that impede you. It's all in the mind, the shackles and chains, the doubts that can blind, the fear that constrains, the freedom to float, to live unconfined. It's all in the mind.
But she's always right here.
So you close a door inside and hide.
Hide where?
In a secret place you'll find, where you're free and unentwined.
But how?
Haven't you ever been in conversation and your mind drifted somewhere else? Or been in a room surrounded by people and yet felt a million miles away?
Oh, yes, I have.
Of course.
Well, that's where to go. When you want to be alone, you can go there right now if you really want to.
We can't disappear like you.
That's not true. Yes, you can. I must go, but I'll return. With some practice, you will learn separating. When you mentally are free, you can come and visit me. I'll be waiting. It's all in the mind, the joy and the dread, the way we're defined, the lies we've been fed, the key to escape, restrictions that bind. It's all in the mind. All in the
Thank you, Your Honor. Won't you please forgive me if I seem emotional for these poor deformed girls? They're incapable of a life of their own. Disabled from birth, they need a full-time guardian to assist them day and night. Though I've lost my better half, I'm willing to do what's right.
The court made us sir's property.
Is to do with as he pleased.
Completely under his control for the rest of our lives.
Trusting us with your story.
It's shameful.
No, it's inspiring. Look at all you've survived.
It feels good to finally tell someone.
You need to tell it to a court.
I could never do that.
Why not? You have truth on your side.
And me. Once I get your story out there, every man in this country will want to defend you. And every woman will want to be your friend.
You have a high opinion of yourself.
I have a high opinion of you. Bunny? Now, Daisy, you have always wanted to be on stage. Just think of testifying as another performance. Most trials are won and lost before anyone even steps foot in a courtroom. First, we need to get you looking beautiful. New hairstyles, makeup, dresses, not those dresses. Less Jean Harlow, more Mary Pickford. Next, you need to find a reporter. Someone who will present your story in the most sympathetic light. If you win your freedom, what do you intend to do?
Have a cocktail. Have a man.
No, no. Bunny, let's show them. If you win your freedom, what do you intend to do?
Earn a living.
Then?
Share it.
With who?
Orphans.
And people with disabilities greater than our own.
Good. Now, onto the testimony. We'll find a great lawyer. Someone charming, handsome, sophisticated. Did sir ever beat you?
Yes, he did. Sometimes with the buckle of his belt.
How many hours a day does he make you work?
16.
16? 7 days a week.
Even on Sundays? And what does he pay you for all that work?
Not one thin dime.
Wait, is that really true? This is gonna be easier than I thought! Do you trust me?
Yes.
Great. We've got a lot of work to do, so let's get started. Those two have faced so many trials. I faced few of my own. Now our facts are linked, 'cause I had a hunch when I passed that sideshow. The whole damn country's on the edge of its seat, 'cause the trial of the century's about to begin. And who the hell knows, we just might win. Thank you. think they're ready? Funny. They're more than ready. They're perfect. Now you girls have nothing to worry about. Just remember what we told you.
We'll see you inside.
Why do I feel like I swallowed a butterfly? Tickling inside makes me laugh till I want to cry. Why are my eyes turning moist while my throat is dry? Is it that handsome guy? Why are my feelings racing around inside? Will I explode if all of my thoughts collide? One minute brave, the next minute terrified.
Those are feelings you have brought to hide.
I can't hide, but I feel the way that you do.
What do you mean? I'm not in love.
Many things in my life, Your Honor. I
can't rightly say why any human being ought to be treated like someone else's property. I watched this man abuse these girls for 10 years.
What are you doing?
What do you hire me to do? Protect the girls. Everything they said is true, Your Honor.
Your Honor, we'd like to call for the judgment.
The council will convene in my chambers at once. Direct from their triumph in court. Your girls painted me as being quite the ogre. But your fabricated stories cannot compare with the truth I've learned about your friend here.
Why be a sore loser? Let's shake hands and go our separate ways.
I don't shake hands with liars.
What are you talking about?
Oh, I have friends too. And I've been doing some masquerade around. Mr. Connor hasn't worked the Orphan Circuit for at least 2 years now.
You need better sources. I just signed a new deal with the Circuit yesterday. And the first act I booked was the Hilton sisters.
But you told us you already worked for them.
So he lied a little. Doesn't everyone in show business? Violet, he may not be perfect, but he's a lot better than what we've had.
Go ahead! You can't be alone with this scum. Good luck to you.
You, what are you doing here?
Just came to get my things.
I should have known better than to trust your kind. Time for us to move on. Clearly this well has been poisoned. We leave at dawn. Unless any of you has any perfect other offers. And as for you and Grace, you will find out soon enough just what I've been trying to protect you from!
What have we done? Lost our home, closed our door,
opened more.
Looks like their hearts might break, saying goodbye to you.
backstage as we toured the show. Nothing for you here, so why not go?
Yes, say yes, please come along.
Nothing lost if I decide to. I feel I belong beside.
Thank you.
mistake. Did you see what's going on out there? There must be 1,000 people lined up at that stage door just to get a look at the girls.
Or it sure beats a crowd at a sideshow.
Gentlemen.
We did it!
Well, they did it.
Yes, they did it, but we're a team. Jake, you take such good care of our girls. And buddy, I always knew you'd be the one to turn them into stars!
I actually enjoyed myself.
That makes me so happy.
If we always get kisses, we'll try even harder.
Kisses are a tiny reward.
Not for us.
Well, then get ready for another.
And another.
Good night.
Give a question to the hospital.
You can lie to yourself. I won't. No one could love a Siamese twin. Nobody wants us. No one ever has. No one ever will. Why are you trying to kill my dream?
It's a dream. It's a nightmare. Wake up. Look around.
God, we've been blessed.
Marry me, Violet.
Marry me, Daisy.
Make me happy the rest of my life.
Marry me, Daisy.
Marry me, Violet. Why can't we be husband and wife?
I warned you about my circumstances, how old romances fell through. Dad's business caused my love life to be fractured. He manufactured strong glue. But you persisted anyway, and now it seems you're here to stay. Dad's product has made one where there were two, and now I'm stuck with you. Oh yes, I'm stuck with you. Guess there are words.
Ray, you need to match what we're doing on this side, all right?
Don't listen to him, Ray. You do everything perfectly.
Daisy, I'm just trying to polish this number. You know, if you spent half as much time learning these steps as you do flirting...
Flirting? Oh, you mean like this?
What's the matter, buddy?
Nothing. Nothing. It's just a little choreography problem. We're fine.
I told you. It was a mistake putting yourself in this number.
I'm working it out.
Oh, Ray and I can work out our problems in private. You want to watch, buddy?
Take five, everyone.
Daisy, there are people around.
So?
We're trying to sell you and Violet as typical girls next door.
Typical girls have boyfriends. You want to be mine?
Shameless flirt, showing some interest couldn't hurt. Some, you show the maximum.
So you prefer I act like you, afraid of your feelings, afraid they're taboo. How will your body ever have a clue that you love him through and through?
Don't say that.
of peace with me. Jake, looking fine. Some digs, huh?
Sure is a long way from the sideshow.
Let me tell you, success is even sweeter when you've been on the bottom. You know, I never asked, where did Sir find you? Georgia? Louisiana?
Hackensack.
And look at you now, from that seedy tent to working the highest paid act in vaudeville.
The two don't seem that different. The girls are working just as hard, if not harder.
And they need to rake it in while they can. I'm looking for a new angle, something to get us to whatever's next. Radio? Recording career?
Hell, they could even be movie stars, right?
They're pretty enough. And Daisy's got the charisma, but I don't think those special effects guys can make a whole person disappear. Tell the girls it's time for their entrance.
Yeah.
You and Ray have been spending a lot of time together.
Yeah. So?
Ah, here they come. Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention? Thanks for attending our party. We'll cheer as the new year begins. Let's hear one now, make it hearty. Here they are, the Hilton Twins.
Hating New Year's Eve together.
I mean, at least we'll have someone to kiss at midnight.
Right, a friendly peck on the cheek.
Oh, I was thinking more than just a peck.
Don't get carried away.
Well, why not? I'm with my favorite girl.
You're just being nice.
No, Violet. You mean the world to me. Why don't we make this New Year's Eve one we'll remember forever? I love you, you know.
Oh, please.
I do. And I know you love me. So now that I've said it, could I see a smile?
How's this?
Come on. What do I have to do? Beg you on my knees?
Don't you dare.
I'm getting down on one knee and I'm begging you to smile.
You're embarrassing me.
I'm making you laugh a little.
What's going on over there, buddy? Looks like you're proposing.
He's making fun of me.
I am not. Violet refuses to believe I love her.
You do?
Well, of course.
Then you are proposing.
He's not.
Would that make you happy?
It couldn't hurt.
What a story that would make.
Can I be your maid of honor?
Stop it! All of you, stop making fun of me!
No, Violet. Don't be upset. That's the last thing that I want.
I'm sorry. I can't joke about this.
This isn't a joke.
Violet, I love you. I don't know how else to say it. I cherish each moment I spend with you. You see things the same way as I do.
Violet Hilton, you make me so happy. Allow me to do the same. Marry me.
If you don't say yes, I'm going to have a heart attack that will kill us both.
What are you waiting for? What's so hard?
I'm caught by surprise, caught off guard. Never even hoped for happiness. Now I'm trusting my heart. I'm saying yes, buddy. I'll marry you.
Now we'll no longer be alone.
Not alone.
We've got someone to call our own.
You're my love.
I will make you my home. And that is where I'll stay.
Let's make this public. For New Year's Day. Ladies and gentlemen, the hour is upon us, and I have big news which to welcome the new year. The lovely Miss Violet Hilton has accepted a marriage proposal from Mr. Buddy Foster.
I propose a toast to these lovebirds here. Let's raise a glass and our voices in cheer. Here's to a new love.
May it be true love.
Love is from true love. And a happy new year. A happy new year.
They'd root twice as much for a double wedding.
You surprised me. First a threesome, and now you want to up the ante.
That's not what I meant. It's just... Violet getting married is bound to be hard on Daisy.
Daisy can take care of herself.
I'm sure she wants exactly what Violet and I have.
And what is that? Exactly.
Violet is my better half. She makes me the person I want to be. Doesn't Daisy do that for you?
Hey! You mind your business!
It's just... there's such an obvious connection between you two.
Thank you.
seemed obvious connection. I tried so hard to hide. Couldn't even say it to myself. And obvious connection I tried to push aside into a corner on the darkest shelf. We'll never be alone. My feelings can't be shown. So I try to imagine and replay all the things I'll never get to say. You're wrapped up with another, tangled and entwined. I invent a separation in the pride. That I haven't heard in store. For how can I conquer, ignore, can fight? Someone else is always at your side. I want to tell you.
I want. My own.
You have to share me.
Oh no, I want you alone. No. I imagine us so well. How you dance and taste and smell. I can imagine being with you, but I don't have the guts to follow through. You're one half of a couple. That's how you are defined. And my only constellation is a private conversation in my place.
I never sought the spotlight. I stayed behind the scenes. But then I met a sweetheart who chased my old routines. She put me in the spotlight. Now I'm a happy pup. And when I count my blessings, I find they all add up to 1 + 1 = 3. My baby, her sister, and me. This is not what I expected, but my baby is well connected. You can see why I elected this arithmetic with an odd key, where 1 + 1 = 3.
Out of the groom and the bride, the sister's head kept getting in the frame.
Would it help if I cut off my head?
Oh, she's a pistol.
When are we going to see this newsreel in a theater?
Oh, when bigamy becomes legal?
Well, actually, I found a state that believes in the power of love and rights for anyone who wants to be wed.
And where is that?
Texas!
Yeah, good luck, kid. I hope your rifle is double-barreled.
You think you're the first person to make that joke?
Hey, how about a little enthusiasm?
Texas? You promised we'd never have to go back there. Jake, can you give me some champagne?
This wedding is going to be the grand finale of the Texas Centennial. Right on the 50-yard line of the Cotton Bowl. You'll be on every front page in the nation.
Oh, good. So the whole country can joke about me.
Daisy, I am sorry people can be so crude, but this is going to make you more famous than ever.
Oh, me? Is anyone going to give me that drink?
It's a bit early in the day.
We're not getting married, so don't think you can tell me what to do.
Daisy, look at me. I didn't want to tell you this until I was absolutely certain, but I have news that's going to make you very happy. I've been consulting with some of the best medical minds in the country. Their consensus is that the two of you could be successfully separated.
Doctors have been telling us that our whole lives.
We were also told one of us could die.
Just last month at Harvard, so surgeons operated on a pair of conjoined twins with a link twice as complex as yours. And tonight, those twins sleep in separate bedrooms. Think of it. Violet, you could finally be like everyone else, and Daisy, the whole world at your feet.
But Terry, even if that were possible, we wouldn't be your big attraction if we weren't together.
Vaudeville is over. Movies is where the action is, where you should be.
Us?
No. You.
You want to know what I dream about? Sitting in a plush movie theater, holding my husband's hand, and watching you do all the work for a change.
I couldn't go to Hollywood on my own.
You wouldn't be on your own. The decision's yours, of course, but think what this could mean for all of us. Take it out!
I'm absolutely stunned.
I don't know what to think.
It's a mistake! You should have messed with what God created!
We're God's mistakes.
No, you're not. You don't know your own worth.
I finally have the chance to be loved.
By someone who wants to change you completely?
Jake, you may be our closest friend, but this is between us.
I want your happiness more than anything, but I don't trust this.
What do you know about it?
I know plenty. I know how someone should love you.
And how is that?
You should be loved by someone who knows you, wants you to blossom, always is true. You should be cherished like the first sign of springtime. You should be loved. You should be loved with constant devotion, heart-pounding passion flooding you through. You should be treasured like a ruby or a diamond. You should be loved in the way I love you. Whispers at night.
sorry, Jake. But I love Buddy.
One of these days, you will look back in shame. You'll be alone, and you'll know you're to blame. You will regret how you pushed love aside when you're married to nothing! By someone who wants you, tries to protect you, always is true. You should have chosen the one who supports you, always supports you, whatever you do, yes.
Is it all for display?
kid. I haven't forgotten your cakes. So, how's things? How's the sideshow?
Haven't heard? Completely.
First the girls left, then the do-gooders tried to save us from being exploited.
All they saved us from was being fed.
We couldn't find work anywhere, but now the three of us have a bakery.
I take care of managing the supplies and ordering the accounts,
and I take care of the customers at the front of the store.
She sells fortunes in the back.
Ah.
You can't live by cake alone, you know.
We're so happy for Violet.
She's our inspiration. They both are.
I just hope they get everything they deserve.
Of course they will. I've looked into my crystal ball. A rosy future is in sight.
That's what you always say.
And darling, I'm always right. Come on, let's go see our girl get married.
For me, the thought of all those people is terrifying. Daisy, can we just get through the ceremony and then decide about the operation?
Of course. We can discuss it tonight, during the honeymoon.
Don't be a brat.
What's wrong? You girls should be happy for each other.
How did you get back here?
Jake!
It's your big wedding day, isn't it?
You weren't invited.
No, I bought my ticket like the rest of the guests. All those close friends you've never met. I spent my last cent to be here.
What do you want?
When you girls left, I lost everything. I need a job. Please, I'll do anything. You know I'm a hard worker. And Daisy, wouldn't you like to boss me around for a change?
Hey! Oh my God. You're not welcome!
Don't! Jake, looking quite the gentleman.
You want me to throw you out?
No, no! Just have a chat. The time for me to take my seat is a brilliant chance. Congratulations, Violet.
Well, we can't have him ruin this day, can we? Violet, I always knew you would make a beautiful bride.
You're very kind, Jake.
Listen, it's hard for me to say this, but I'm going to be heading out after the wedding.
What do you mean?
It's time to move on. A fellow I know in Chicago owns a little club. I need someone to work with performers. Thanks to you two, I have experience with that.
But we need you. Please don't go.
Violet, you know I've never been able to say no to you. But this time I have to.
Happy wedding day!
What a crowd out there.
Buddy, it's bad luck if you see me before the ceremony.
Oh, who believes in those wives' tales anymore?
Get out, buddy.
Is something wrong?
Jake's leaving. He got a job in Chicago.
Jake, your timing could have been better, but congratulations. I'm glad you could find work somewhere.
I've been working my whole life, Terry. Not just for you and the girls. Buddy, you better be real good to Violet. She deserves better. If you hurt her, I will hunt you down.
Jake, what's happened? I always thought of us as friends.
He loves her. He truly does.
I do, buddy. More than you ever can. So come on, tell the truth. Be a man.
He's right, Violet. You deserve better.
Buddy!
I tried.
But I'm playing a part I've tried, and it's breaking my heart.
You don't love me.
I do, Violet, but not in the way you want. I'm not that strong of a man.
But you're the one I love.
You should be loved by someone like Jake. Somebody strong who's able to take whatever comes along. I'm not ready yet for a step we'd both regret. If only I'd known it before, hurting you this way hurts me even more.
Bunny, you need to get a hold of yourself!
I have!
Violet, don't cry. It's for the best.
How can you say that?
Buddy, why don't you tell her what's really going on? Yeah,
this is between your sister and me.
She may be blind, but I'm not. You have it lucky. Unlike the rest of us, you can hide what makes you different.
Daisy.
Don't be cruel.
Excuse me. No one is allowed back here.
I'm quite sure I am.
And who the hell are you?
Todd Browning, MGM.
Mr. Browning!
The movie director?
And you must be the Hilton sisters. Lovely. Lovely.
And you, you're the groom.
He's not. The wedding is off.
Violet, did I hear you correctly?
Yes, you did.
What a shame. I came all the way from Hollywood. I intended to offer you roles in my new film.
Oh, we could still be in your film.
I don't. Without the publicity from the wedding.
I have a solution. Marry me, Terry.
With the whole world expecting a different pair.
They're expecting a wedding of a Siamese twin. They won't care.
Smart girl.
Marry me, Terry. It makes so much sense. I know.
Right after the operation.
What operation?
You know, Mr. Browning, it's really uncanny of you to show up like this. I was just planning on pursuing a movie career for Daisy. I found doctors who could separate her from Violet.
Separate? No. No, I'm interested in them as they are.
As we are?
Of course. There's no one like you. You're unique.
That's what you said, Terry. When we first met.
A lot has changed since then. Mr. Browning, thank you for your interest, but I have other plans for the girls.
And who the hell are you?
Who am I? I'm the guy that made all this happen. I'm the only reason why you are here. Without me, these girls would be in some shithole tent in Texas instead of a stadium filled with 50,000 people waiting for a wedding that is going to happen as soon as you pull your pantyhose together and marry this
what? Say it! Mr. Browning, there's not going to be an operation. We came into this world together, and we'll leave it the same way.
And what about the wedding? Still planning to cancel?
No. My sister was prepared to sacrifice a lot for my dream. I'm happy to return the favor.
Do I have anything to say about this?
Buddy, it's just for show. Besides, you'll be famous. She's right. We can all meet for lunch in Hollywood and pretend we're friends.
We wouldn't have to pretend, would we?
Mr. Browning, you have your movie stars.
We can discuss contracts after the ceremony.
Oh, that won't be necessary.
Daisy, don't confuse business with emotion.
I'm not confused. We don't want to work with you. Goodbye, Terry. Mr. Browning, what's the name of our film?
Free!
Stood on our tiptoes, we could peer.